Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone, let's us introduce ourselves. We are from Group 8 Excellent Class. We have 3 members in our group. There are Siti Nur Hasanah, Dewi Arsyida, and Luvita Pamela. We will present our video about illegal fishing in Indonesia. Please enjoy the video. Indonesia is a country surrounded by ocean. Geographically, the location of Indonesia is very strategic, where it is located between 2 continents and 2 oceans, so that it has the potential of land and sea natural resources that are very abundant. This location makes Indonesia as an archipelago with the longest and widest coastline in the world. Indonesia itself also has a nickname as a maritime country. A maritime state itself is a country that makes optimal use of its sea area in the context of shipping in general. According to the Directorate General of Marine Space Management, Indonesia's ocean area is 2/3 of the country's total sea area of 5.9 million km, consisting of 3.2 million km of territorial sea and 2.7 million km is Indonesia's Exclusive Economic Zone, ZEEI. This makes Indonesia has the potential of abundant fishery resources. In Indonesia's vast marine waters, it contains large fishery resources. According to the Food and Agricultural Organization, FAO, the sustainable potential of Indonesia's marine fishing resources reaches about 6.5 million tons per year, with utilization rates reaching 5.71 tons per year. Indonesian marine world is also seen from the biodiversity of marine life. The Indonesian sea has 8,500 species of fish, 555 species of seaweed, and 950 species of coral reef biota. Various kinds of Indonesian marine world can be managed by the community, like fishermen who catch fish and sell it to meet daily needs, increasing the country's foreign exchange by exporting this marine product to other countries. The potential of Indonesian ocean natural resources is not only an advantage for Indonesia, but can also be a threat if not processed and maintained properly. The abundance of fishery resources in Indonesia's marine water has attracted the attention of foreigners to also be able to enjoy it illegally through illegal fishing activity.
Understanding illegal fishing according to the International Plan of Action, or IPOA, which is interpreted as IUU fishing or illegal, unreported, Unregulated fishing is a fishery activity that is carried out illegally. Activities that are not regulated by existing regulations or activities are not reported by the head of an institution or fisheries management agency that has been available. According to Law No. 45 of 2009 Article 1 on fisheries statute, that fishing is an activity to obtain fish in waters that are not in a state of cultivation by any means or means, including activities that use ships to transport, store, cool, handle, process, and preserve them. Illegal fishing activities are often carried out by local fishermen and foreign fishermen from neighboring countries in the region who enter Indonesian waters illegally. Through various modes of operation, the foreign fishermen catch fish in Indonesian waters and are then traded outside Indonesia with double profits. In Indonesia, there is still frequent fishing by violating fishing grounds by foreign fishermen in some Indonesian territorial waters. Foreign fishermen who often enter Indonesian territorial waters, among others, come from Thailand, Vietnam, the Philippines, and Malaysia. These foreign fishermen often take fish illegally in Natuna waters, Sulawesi waters, and waters around Maluku and Arafurasi, because the location of these waters is the most vulnerable to illegal fishing activities. Illegal fishing has a negative impact on the country, including damage to the sustainability and sustainability of marine ecosystem. Second, harm to the country's economy, and interferes with the sovereignty of the Republic of Indonesia. The causes of illegal fishing activities in Indonesian waters include limited Indonesian marine surveillance fleets, then still light punishment to foreign fishermen who do illegal fishing. Third, still limited ability of Indonesian fishermen in utilizing the potential of fisheries in Indonesian waters. Other cause is the occurrence of overfishing or mercatch in neighboring countries that then look for catchment areas in Indonesia to meet their production and marketing needs. The ability to monitor every movement of surveillance patrol boats at sea can be known by foreign fishing vessels because of sophisticated communication tools. So, the results of operations are not optimal. overcome illegal fishing that occur where it is very detrimental to the state. There are several ways that Indonesia does, including first, add a fleet of marine supervisors. Now, Indonesia has a fleet of 30 fishery surveillance vessels, but the number is still insufficient. According to the Ministry of Marine Affairs and Fisheries, the ideal number of surveillance vessels to be able to monitor Indonesian territorial waters as a whole is as many as 78 ships. Second, establish a marine justice body related to illegal fishing. Indonesia already has a marine judicial agency, the Task Force on Combating Illegal Fishing, or called Satgas 115, which has been quite successful in capturing the existence of illegal fishing actors in Indonesian water. The punishment of perpetrators who are proven to be illegal fishing. Punishment for illegal fishing perpetrators in Indonesia is the main criminal law, consisting of the death penalty, imprisonment, and criminal fines. Present sentence range from 1 until 8 years and fines from 200 million to 2 billion rupiah. Other punishments carried out by Indonesia are also in the form of sinking ships. Improve facilities and infrastructure and aid equipment used to disrupt illegal fishing. Currently, the Ministry of Marine Affairs and Fisheries is considered to have standard of fulfillment of facilities and infrastructure, but it still needs to be improved. By establishing cooperation with Norway, it is expected to reduce the practice of illegal fishing by developing technology to find out the movement of illegal fishing vessels by sharing information and technology with Norway.
Kalau itu bisa terjadi, maka
berantas illegal fishing, Indonesia dan Norwegia sepakat kerjasama. Trenggono menyebutkan praktik illegal fishing merupakan persoalan global yang perlu disikapi bersama. Setiap negara harus bersuara dan menunjukkan langkah konkret dalam memerangi praktik yang dapat merusak populasi biota laut ini. Dia sepakat dengan aturan sejumlah negara yang memperlakukan ketentuan penelusuran produk-produk perikanan yang masuk ke suatu negara. Dengan begitu, bisa diketahui pasti dari mana ikan berasal dan bagaimana proses produksinya. Selain penelusuran produk perikanan, penerapan teknologi untuk mengetahui pergerakan kapal-kapal pelaku illegal fishing juga perlu didorong. Dalam hal ini, pemerintah Indonesia mengajak Norwegia bekerja sama mengembangkan teknologi tersebut. Di antaranya, bisa berupa berbagi informasi dan teknologi untuk mencegah pencurian ikan.
The solution carried out by Indonesia is good enough, but it needs to be added to the number of Indonesian marine surveillance ship fleets to be safer. Then,
For the sinking of ships belonging to five region, illegal fishing occurred should not be burned and thrown. If the condition of the ship is still suitable for use, should be given to fishermen or seized for the country. If the ship is burned and sunk, then the government needs to think hard to dispose of incendiary waste in the sea so as not to pollute the environment and marine life. Law enforcement effort in the form of sinking ship must be accompanied by adequate facility budget support in their enforcement.